Welcome back, everyone, to Kona. I'm Lady Lilia. We are in a cabin, and we just survived from dying in the horrible, unexpected blizzard that just appeared out of nowhere. That's very strange, but we did end up filling up our health and our warm stat and everything, so we're actually fine now. We're good to go. We're gonna go back to the car and hopefully get out of this miserable situation and make our way to the general store, which is where we need to be. Yes! Okay. We've got the chains on the tires. Hopefully we can back out. We do have a big truck after all, so yeah, we're fine. Wow, that was easy. That was very easy. Don't run into the car again, Carl. Carl? Okay, good, good. Same radio station? Lovely. You know, adds to the cheery mood. Kind of need a cheery mood. Okay, Carl, I'm advising you to go really slow, because as you can tell, the roads are horrendous right now. Okay, that you're going a little bit fast there, Carl. Okay, that's a bit more reasonable. Man. When the roads are this bad in my car, I go like 2 miles an hour. Plus, you can't even see, like, if there was another car coming, there'd be no way to even see it. We'd smash right into it. Is it just me, or is it getting worse, by the way? Is it just... I can't... Okay, now it's a little bit better. I don't know. Okay. There's a sign. What does this say? Manistan region.
Spread out on a few acres of untouched forest, bellowing caribou, everlasting snow, and undefiled lakes. The Manistan region was no tourist hub. It was said to have been populated for millennia by Cree people, and ever since the industrial era, by the metal mining industry.
Okay. It sounds like this, dude, 1556? What was that? Ooh, let's get out.
Carl's military training had made him a very punctual man. Being late to his meeting with Hamilton was out of the question.
Yeah, Hamilton, that's his name. It sounds like he might be kind of invading these people's land. By the way, I can look all the way around me this way, but not this way. I guess that's because I can put my arm on the seat or something, and I can't do that this way. I don't know. Anyways, due to military training, we must go forward. Down this hill. Whee! There's houses around, though. Like, I feel like I should be exploring them. Can I look at my map while I'm in the car? Oh, I can! Look at that. Look at that. I can't really tell where I am, though. Manistan's SUD. Am I down, way down south? No. Nope.
Now wasn't a good time to wander about. Hamilton was still out there.
All right,
the
fine.
Running on fumes. Good thing that the general store was close by.
Well, if freaking Carl hadn't left the truck running the entire time when we were getting stuff, then maybe we would have fuel left. Okay, that was some kind of a loading screen there. Hello. Yay, the general store. Adorable gas station. Can I fill up? There we go.
The pumps wouldn't surrender their divine nectar so easily. In all likelihood, they had to be switched on from inside the store.
So no one works here? Okay, I don't know if I would call gas divine nectar, but, I mean, to each his own.
A milkman had to drive by every week to fill the bottles. The fresh milk indicated a recent visit.
All right. Wouldn't they get frozen out here?
Something fell to the bottom of the box.
Oh. I need a key for that. Oh. Hello, doggies. Are those...
Maintaining his composure, Carl recalled something from his military
training.
Those
are wolves.
Wolves always stay away from populated areas. Wait, was it about bears?
No, I think that's correct. I have a strange feeling this is going to be an abandoned general store. What were they eating? A letter. Let it be known.
Hate was in the air. Seems like some villagers barely tolerated each other.
Let it be known you're nothing more than a brigand, a robber, a garbage hoarder, a viper, a leech, a monster. You're holding a knife at my throat. Too bad for me, but... Scribblies. Okay. That's great. Someone does not like Hamilton. Ah, generator?
Carl was no electrician,
but
he could identify a wiring problem when he saw one.
Well, that there looks like a broken wire. Duct tape and some pliers should do the trick, Carl. What is this?
Carl was used to strange phenomena, but a chunk of ice like this? As if an iceberg came out of the ground?
That is really
weird.
That
was a first.
We'll keep that one, right, Carl? Oh, and the tracks. Keep it.
Prints? Carl found a surprise at every turn. Was the camera faulty, or was there a possible lead?
Well... So, like... They're coming from this, so... Some kind of... Magical, mystical ice beast has gone this way? That seems a little... weird. Okay, can I just put that away? Like, can I just not have that in my hand? Hello? Take a picture of the toilets! No, okay, I can't even fit in there. Ah, tab. Okay, tab. No, I can't fit in there. That's great. Oh. Okay, there's an icy trail. Eastern Atamapec.
Carl felt that the store and its surroundings still held their secrets.
Ooh.
And he didn't like to miss out.
I don't want to throw it away, game. Alright, you know what? Before we go this way more... We're definitely going to check out the general store and whatever else it has to offer.
Carl wondered how long he would have to endure this skin-stinging cold.
Fine, I'll go inside. Just wanted to explore. I need some warm clothing or something. Okay, we don't have the key, so no doubt we'll find the key somewhere around. Missing a log. Okay. What about this door? Nope. Do they keep the key in the trash can? Do they keep the key under the door? Do they... Can I break in? No. Carl, turn your car off! So no wonder you freaking run out of gas all the time. Oh, I can just go in there. Oh!
Carl had no trouble recognizing his employer.
No!
He had been killed. There was no need to be a detective to figure that out.
Uh-huh.
But only a detective could have noticed that the killer had to have been very close. That the fatal blow had been given before the victim even realized.
Oh. I shall take a picture. So that's Hamilton. He's dead. He's very dead. Keep it. Very nice music. Pardon me, sir.
Carl felt a chill down his spine and had a terrifying realization. If Hamilton was dead, then who was going to pay him?
I was just going to say that as a joke. That's hilarious. Huh? I saw something. Oh. Mysterious unbranded cans? So mysterious.
What could be inside that envelope? Carl was taken aback. He knew this address. It was said to be the address of the P.O. box for the Canadian Secret Service.
Oh. Mr. John Vaughn, Montreal. Can I open it? Open it. Okay, or not. Kona Cola! Oh!
An explosion suddenly occurred outside.
The power has gone out. Select or validate? Wait, what? Oh, am I trying to open? Okay, I don't know. I don't know what that is yet. That's... Hello?
Carl knew that Gilles Lachance was in charge of the general store.
Gilles.
That made him one of Hamilton's employees. A very angry employee, as Carl could plainly see.
You know what, Hamilton? I have a frog in my throat. And when people have a frog in their throat, they do not take risks by going to work. Customers could catch it, right? I'm a wise man. Not to worry, I will have a nice doctor's note, which I'm going out to get right now. Sadly, in the meantime, I will have to close down the shop unless you would like to come fill in for me. I wouldn't dare advise you, after all. You must know how it's done, since it's yours now. With kind regards, your dedicated manager, Gil. Gil. Right. Okay. Turn on pump number 2. That's right. Good. And then, Up we go. What are we doing up here? What are we? Oh. Sherry wine. Okay. If it's dark, it's recommended to use a flashlight or a lantern. Can I just turn the lights on? Oh, of course. The power's out. Let's go sort that out before we finish in here.
Carl was no electrician, but he could identify a wiring problem when he saw one.
So that was supposed to have happened. I think I found that a little too soon. I'm assuming that's what the explosion was. Hello? Okay, garage off. Store on. Electricity from generator. Mains. All right, so we just need to fiddle around and find, is 4 my flashlight? No, what's my flashlight? It's showing me, like, buttons for the freaking controller. How do I, oh, am I using it now? Okay, I don't think I'm using it, but no, I'm not. All right. Hang on. Equipment, flashlight. There we go. All right. The general store also serves as a post office for the locals. Okay. Quebec's Klondike. Very interesting. Secretary wouldn't be luxury in here. To open the cash register, punch the price, 2 numbers minimum, press sale, turn the crank 2 times, punch the machine if it doesn't work. Okay. 2 numbers and then press sale, turn the crank 2 times. Okay.
Jumping from that height was akin to tempting death. Perhaps that man on the snowmobile had seen enough of this world already.
Perhaps he has.
A nice picture of the Magasin Lachance store, seemingly taken the day it was first opened. It feels frozen in time, from an era long forgotten.
Aw, I love old pictures like that.
Amateur hunters showing some pride at having killed a nice pelted beast. With men like this roaming the area, wolves would become extinct within 10 years, Carl thought.
Poor wolfies. Ooh. I'll take those fire starters. Is there any other stuff I can loot that I'm missing out on here? Pearl jasmine. Aw, kitty food. Can I have a kitty? Rice crunchies. These are great. petite ciao. Okay. Very nice layout. Oh, trash can? Nope, nothing in the trash can. Oh, there's something here. Oh, never mind. Okay. Sorry if you can hear my cat howling in the background. Excuse me? Excuse me? Can I activate that, please? Oh, the place is a mess. Right, yes, of course it is. It's because something horrible happened here. Did I see a thing for me to click on? No. Right, okay. Now, do I remember what... Oh. Yeah. Oh. That's odd. What is in there? Is that, like, seed or something? Aha! Hello! I need that.
According to that log, it seemed like the whole village owed some money to the general store. Carl was far more interested in the bunch of nearby addresses he had just gotten his hands on, though.
I remember that one. That's weird. Why would everyone owe the general store money? Was the general store guy blackmailing everyone? That would be bad. Oh, take that. Sometimes it's kind of hard to see those little knobs. Does not work. Okay.
The snowstorm pummeled everything in its path. Carl was not surprised when he heard no tone.
Okay, so... price? 19 cents. Press the sale button. Aha! Ticket. Take it all, Carl. Or just take the post key. Oh, the post key we can use out front here. And this?
A radiator without power is as good as a wood stove without logs.
Okay. Let's go back outside. Put that away. Now we can open this. Oh!
The murder weapon.
Oh!
What was that doing there, Carl wondered. Hamilton must have been determined to keep some information secret to post this key. Shame he got unlucky. Everything made sense now.
Really?
Poor Hamilton's denunciation was interrupted, and he figured it would be best to lock everything up and send the key to his correspondent, who would receive the box later on. Clever, but not enough. That's what happens to ordinary people playing spy.
Okay. It is as a citizen of Her Majesty in the free economic chambers of the world that I must address what follows to the proper authorities. The worst is happening at this very moment. I cannot write at length, but I am requesting immediate help from my country. I believe the free world is in grave danger. A member of my community, the Honorable Blankety Blank. Ah, darn it. Of course he got killed right when in the mean... Wait, how did he put that in here if he was killed while writing it? The murderer must have put that in there, right? Otherwise, that doesn't make any sense. Okay. I think I can get some gas now.
The pumps wouldn't surrender their divine nectar so easily.
Oh, right.
In all likelihood, they had to be switched on from inside the store.
Okay, let's see if we can fix the thingamadinger now.
Carl was no electrician,
but
he could identify a wiring problem.
I thought I had pliers. Okay. Clearly, oh, wait, do I have a key for this? I think I got an additional key, didn't I? Maybe not. Oh, I did. Okay, great. All right, a very nice car. Surely there's gonna be pliers in here. There. Hardware. Okay. There we go. That's what I needed. Everyone's, like, tools and things are so nicely organized in this area. Fragile. At least we know it's fragile.
Staring intently at the controls won't be enough to make that lift budge. The poor thing was
lift?
Out of power.
lift. Oh! Oh, this. Okay. So, yeah. Well, we can go fix the power now. So let's go do that. Can I open these doors? No. Don't really need to, so... Just open the door in my face. I always love to hit myself in the face with doors in games. It's one of my favorite pastimes. Yay! I did it! Alright, now... Reset the breakers? Or maybe... Ah, there we go. To the mains. Are they on? On. On.
The note explained that the garage and the store couldn't be supplied with electricity at the same time.
Ah, okay. We'll turn the garage off then. So wait, what is mains? Electricity turned off. Electricity from power line. Electricity from generator. We want from generator, right? Because we just fixed the generator? Do I turn it on? Oh, turn it on. There we go. There we go. Okay, generator fixed. Reset the breaker. Aha! Wait, that's off? Or that's on? Huh. Alright, well, can I now turn the lights on? No, I didn't think so, because it doesn't seem like it's on. That must just be the emergency light. Okay. There we go! Also, that needed power, too. Okay, so, now, pump number two is green! Green means go. What's that? Oh, it's a cigarette. Okay. Once again, I'm disappointed at how Carl just leaves his car on all the time. Also, you're not supposed to... Leave your car on while you're fueling it, Carl. I'm sure you should know that. You are a detective, after all. But I'm
Carl
not gonna...
knew straight away where to find the infuriated Gilles Lachance. Any good investigation would have to start there.
Wait. I know where to find him already? Seriously? Hmm. Well, I still need to go into the garage. We need to power. Excuse me. Eh. Okay. So now. It's kind of inconvenient that they can't have power to both places at once. Most inconvenient. Hello? Where is the lights? Aha! There's no overhead lighting in here? Yeah, there is. Ah, very nice. Okay. There it is. Ah.
At long last, the crowbar was within Carl's grasp.
I mean...
Surely it would come in handy at some point.
I can attack with it, but to be honest, I didn't see it there before game, so, you know, it's fine though. I forgive you. Okay. I now have a weapon, which is probably very useful. I don't know if I need to make fires outside for any particular reason yet. Okay, let me check my stats. We're doing pretty good. I do have a first aid kit. Actually, let's do a save. Oh, never mind. Let's not do a save. But we should be able to drive off now, right? Because I have fuel, I have everything that I need, I think. Let's go see if he lets me get back in my car now. Yep. Okay, good. Stress. Getting better. Alright. Now can I save? No. So... where am I going this way now? So am I going to be going and investigating those houses? Oh. Because I did get some, addresses, and I know I passed
Carl was
one.
Beginning to know the store and its surroundings like the back of his hand. The Seeker had sought.
I mean, okay, whatever you say. I sure don't know like the back of my hand, but I do know that the general store is right. Oh, we actually do have a little blip on the map. Yeah, there's a tiny arrow. So we passed. I wish I could make notes on the map. That'd be nice. So we can't go south because there's a tree in the way. At least I assume that's south. Yeah, I think so. So we're gonna have to go back north? Possibly? Okay, so this way should be to the residential areas? I think? Maybe? So where does it say I'm at right now? Yeah, okay. 10 miles per hour, Carl. I can't see what your speed is, but I would say this is about 10. Don't go faster or the bridge might collapse. That looks dangerous right there. Okay. I hope nothing horrible happens. Okay. We're still fine. God, imagine having to drive over this every day to go to the general store. Western Atamepec. That way to the hospital. Okay. That sounds good. Maybe there's supplies I can grab. Hello? Okay. Alright, so I'm gonna have to get out now. Let's park here. Get out. Again, wish I could turn the car off. But I guess I could just go back and get more gas. Dr. Brewer-Bray's Clinic. Hello? Who leaves their key in their mailbox? That's where it should be. Oh. Loot.
There should be a law forbidding doctors from falling sick.
That's not very fair. Medical emergency in town. The doctor there is sick. I'll be back soon. If he dies, I won't be returning. I'll have to replace him. What? That's horrible.
In spite of Dr. Beaupré's goodwill, the place didn't look much like a physician's office. It could easily be mistaken for a sewing shop.
A sewing shop? Okay, so one is journal. Two is map. Three is camera. And four should be flashlight. It is. Okay, good. No, wait. I don't need to start the fire. I don't want to waste a log right now. Hello? Getting a lot of fire starting kits.
For the one-eyed, or for other vision problems, the eye patch was the way to go.
Attach a wire. Why? Matches. Okay.
Carl got the trembles as he imagined the excruciating pain that kind of scalpel could no doubt inflict.
Yeah.
Within these miserable walls, patients probably felt more like in a slaughterhouse than in a doctor's office.
What? Don't be ridiculous. My nightmare. The scale. Ha 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 ha, very funny. Doctors apparently fascinated by history. Earth doesn't look this big from here. The doctor's apparently fascinated with history. Great. Store in a cool place with a constant temperature, they said. Yeah. Yes! Medical kit!
A chamber pot. Fortunately for Carl, inspecting it wouldn't further this particular investigation.
Ha ha. You're lucky, Carl.
A chamber pot. Fortunately for Carl, inspecting it wouldn't further this particular investigation.
Oh, there's that girl!
The good doctor, flanked by his beautiful spouse. Pure happiness, captured on cardstock.
That's the same chick, isn't
it? Carl recognized this woman's soulful eyes.
Yeah.
Was it Dr. Beaupré, who had hit him head-on at the village border?
Oh, maybe. Okay, are you gonna say something? No. I never did quite catch her name. The men called her Lore. She had a neck wound. There was so much blood. The bullet had done a lot of damage, probably hitting the cerebellum. It was hopeless. She had a cardiac arrest. The men had found her like this, they said. I doubt it, but in a small town like this, it's usually best to turn a blind eye. I've been told to step back from sending out the death certificate. This whole thing sickens me. Oh, there's more! Okay. Oh man, I wonder how many things I've missed by not hitting that. No medical explanation whatsoever can explain why old Rosere is still alive. As we in the trade say, the only way to cure him is to kill him. Rosere Armand. Lacerations. 1925? Huh. Sylvie Bedard. All of her symptoms point to the same root cause. She's pregnant. She refuses it. She denies it. I'm willing to bet her husband is not the father. Let's just hope it's not Everett Lockhart, though. Or she would have an illegitimate child and a syphilis on her hands.
There was no doubt that the doctor and Hamilton knew each other very well.
William Joseph Hamilton. Haughty. Can't be cured. Chronic foot pain. Can't walk long distances. Rich. I'll cure him of that one day. Ha! This is from... Where does it say the date? 1915? Oh, that's probably his birth date. It's a telephone number. His profession, big shot. that's funny. Doesn't say the date of this, though. Alright, that's it. Okay. It's very interesting. That looks...
Doctors used light-reflecting frontal mirrors to look inside the patient's cavities. That was a bit unsettling. But back then, it was pretty much always the case with medicine.
Ew. So, is this guy just like a freaking olden day doctor dude with supplies from the wild, wild west?
Someone had lost a few liters of blood here. Carl's first thought had been a lumber accident, someone's hand cut by a saw, or a hunting accident. In any case, whoever had lost all this blood couldn't have gone far. Perhaps they were already dead.
It wasn't Hamilton. He didn't look bloody. Okay. What else we got? This thing?
A communist manifesto. Only a few years ago, this type of allegiance meant prison time. And even at present, the Western world was very wary of the Soviet threat. Why would the doctor own such a book? Nobody kills a rich patient to start a revolution. It didn't make any sense. He had to dig deeper still to understand. Luckily, that was Carl Faubert's specialty.
Luckily. The history of all hitherto existing society is the history of class struggles. Freeman and slave, patrician and plebeian, lord and serf, guildmaster and journeyman, in a word, oppressor and oppressed, stood in constant opposition to one another, carried on an uninterrupted, now hidden, now open fight. A fight that each time ended either in a revolutionary reconstruction of society at large or in the common ruin of the contending classes. Biggest run-on sentence ever. In the earlier epochs of history, we find almost everywhere a complicated arrangement of society in various orders, a manifold graduation of social rank. In ancient Rome, we have patricians, knights, plebeians, slaves. In the Middle Ages, feudal lords, vassals, guild masters, journeymen, apprentices, serfs. In almost all of these classes, again, subordinate gradations. Change page. No. Okay, that's all we got. Well, I think that's all that we have really in here. Oh. Ah, I could have just done this. Sweet. Painkillers.
Dr. Beaupré had done his medical studies quite far from here. He was surely one of the first students out of the new campus to settle on the mountainside.
Dr. Beaupré. All right, anything that I missed? Oh, his wife. Okay. Should I be reading these journal entries? I guess we should. The young woman. The file seems incomplete. Who is this Cree woman? And what happened to her? Everything points to a certain death, but no death certificate. I'm no doctor, but I know fresh blood when I see it. Someone bled profusely in this office less than 2 days ago. Nothing weird about that. Unless... What do you mean, unless? Of course there's something weird about that. Especially if the doctor's been gone. Hamilton's murder. An envelope torn open, addressed to the Secret Service. If I remember correctly, the whole thing is more intricate than it seems. Is getting rid of the murder weapon by putting it in a mailbox really the best way? No. There most likely won't be any prints on it. I would have to have paid to see the postman's face when he found that thing, though. Another envelope addressed to Vaug from the Street Service. There's a key inside. The killer must not have known it was there, or they would have taken it. I'm a step ahead of them. Or the killer put it there. Investigative hypotheses. I can easily trace back the chains of event. Hamilton wants to send a very confidential denotation letter to the Secret Service in Ottawa. He's planning on sending the letter inside of a locked box, and to send the key separately. It's cumbersome, but he's doing what he can. Excuse me. But something throws him off while he's in a hurry. He locks everything and mails the key, but the box somehow ends up in the killer's hands. When you find death threats and the person threatened is found dead, one could say the case solves itself. Only a shame the note isn't signed. Yeah, but there's no way of knowing that that's related. Like, that might not be the same person, because apparently he was getting a lot of threats, wasn't he? Carl Faubert. This is me. Look how handsome I am. I'm a private detective. It pays the bills along with my veteran's pension from my time in Korea. Usually I'm hired to track unfaithful husbands, but divorces are expensive, so infidelities are scarce these days. William Hamilton hired me. I had a check and many promises, and I really wanted to leave Montreal, and Lake Atamapec is the perfect place to get away. When you want to leave, you leave. And we already know who he is, so... Let's see. C next section or D. Okay, so we don't have anything else there. Right, let's go in here. When locking a door isn't enough. Oh, do I use my crowbar? How do I get that out again? No, not. No. Apparently not. Okay, never mind. Are we done then? Did I already do this? I don't think I did, actually. Toilet paper.
The injured could be recognized by the large stains of red, an informal nickname given to Merbroman, smudged all over their injuries.
Merbroman. There's a snack in there, I see it. Some potatoes.
The good doctor, flanked by his beautiful spouse. Pure happiness captured on cardstock. Carl recognized this woman's soulful eyes. Was it Dr. Beaupré, who had hit him head-on at the village border?
Probably was, I guess. Or it was the murderer. That's why he fled. Why would Dr. Beaupré flee if he wasn't the murderer? Could it be that they are one and the same? I don't know. Let's see if there's anything around back around. Oh, this is the way out. Okay. Please use the other door. Anything suspicious back here? There's a bottle. Oh, what about in here? Yes, duct tape. Hello. Oh, I can go inside this one. I got a lantern. That's gonna be useful. So...
Carl felt like he knew the doctor now. His belongings had spoken lengths about him. But what Carl had heard worried him.
Yeah. That is definitely understandable. I'm worried as well. Alright. Looks like maybe the wolves have been here too. I think we should go now. Probably to the next spot. We've learned about the good Dr. Beaupré. Yes, indeed. And our car is still on. Maybe Carl just really wants to make sure he stays warm, so he leaves it running. So the heat is always is prepared for him, you know. Maybe that's probably it. That's the only thing I can think of anyways. Otherwise, it's just plain irresponsible. Fine, if you don't want to back up correctly, we'll just go in a big circle. Woo! Alright, where to next? This way, I think, is where we were going. Better double check the map. While we're driving, most safe thing ever. Okay, so, been to the doctor. Are we turning into a place right now? I want to look at my map. Game. Yes. Okay. I'm gonna have a car accident because I keep looking at my map while I'm driving. Man. Rosario's house. If I was Carl, I'd be really, really thankful for this truck. Right about now. What if he was driving like a little tiny, you know, Toyota car or something? We would have no chance in the snowy roads. Alright. 20. Oh!
Whoa, my madam.
Whoa, my madam. Hello. Can I come in? Please don't shoot me.
Je m'attendais pas à ce qu'un étranger retentisse par ici. Moi te dire, je prends plus de chance depuis que ça rôde dans ce bout-là. J'ai ma carabine au bout du doigt, et puis bang, 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 si ça s'approche.
Okay. I mean, you almost killed me though, dude.
Si tu veux du linge chaud, parce que t'es habillé comme un gars de la ville, je dirais pas non à une bonne bouteille de caribou. Puis tu pigeras ce que tu voudras parmi mes guenilles.
Oh, so he's gonna trade me warm clothes for some booze? Trade caribou for coat. Yeah, okay. I'll just take this while I'm here. I'll just loot your house as well. You know, I could just like take the jacket. I mean, but he does have a gun, so. No, I'm not crazy. You're crazy. I would love to find some booze. I would love that warm jacket.
Vois-tu le livre là? C'est le Wendigo. Ouais, le Wendigo. Un guerrier qui devient un loup pour se venger de sa grosse peine.
Hmm. There was a time when hate waged war. Our hunters could decimate the great wolves who had taken our children. Our warriors could snap the necks of the cowards who had reached for our supplies. The deafening sound of rock and bone breaking was enough to satiate the hate. I am taking time with it. And the rivers of blood would express our remorse and apologies. Thus was balance maintained. Then came the whites. The legend of the Wendigo dates back to a time before what anyone but the tallest trees can remember. A time of great cold and great aspirations when the ships came and spewed men in their fire cannons. Okay. Plagues and spinelessness. Balance broke forever. The dead were piling up at our ancestral lands. Too many bodies covered in moss. Too much blood spilled on our stone. Our bone-breaking hate did not suffice any longer. Oh god. One day, a young warrior who had lost everything, nieces, brothers, parents, and hope, fell to his knees in the middle of a small clearing covered in blood of his fiancée, killed after having crossed the path of some whites passing by. He had seen everything and called out to the Great Spirit, called out to him with words that came so naturally to him, words that could only create a great river of blood and guts and terrifying roar of screams. He called out to him for a force that no one had before. He became Wendigo. The whites were decimated under the icy claws of the Wendigo. The great tide of blood even pushed a few ships back out to sea. But the Wendigo was not yet done with his vengeance. For as long as the heart of one of his fiancé's murderers still beat on Cree territory, he would prevail. The elders say that it was the force of the ancestors' return to nature that turned the young warrior. In this clearing... Dude, shut up. I'm trying to read. In this clearing where many ancestors had been buried the centuries past, a clearing now covered in blood spilled unjustly in a time where too many bodies were being buried, the ancestors heard the cries of the young warrior. Only in the remarkable time like this could the Wendigo have been born. His vengeance satiated, the warrior became Wendigo, went to rest forever. His frozen heart melted and disappeared. Much like real snow come to spring. The storm that had befallen the Cree lands faded as well. There was much celebration. Balance had been restored, but the whites came back too. White hatred is never satisfied by rock and bone turned to dust. They arrived by the hundreds, armed with guns and torches, burned down every village, raped every woman, smashed the head of every newborn, tortured every man that fell into their grips. Never before had unbalance been so deep for the Cree peoples, and ever since, it has been told that one should be satisfied with the rivers of blood brought by hatred, despite the wrongfulness done to them, because remarkable hate comes at far too steep a price. The Wendigo was never invoked again, but in the hearts of the Cree people remained a fear that one day a young warrior would once again call out the remarkable hate, because they know, through the wisdom brought by this legend, that the Wendigo would prevail, but that this victory would come at a great cost. The whites would come back, the whites would rule, none would be spared. Oh. Well, that would explain the storm, I guess, but... Is it really gonna go that way with like a supernatural direction? I mean, we did see that weird ice thing that looked pretty unnatural. I'll just take this if you don't mind, old man. By the way, he sounds hilarious when he's laughing. Inspect. Don't touch that, you could hurt yourself.
Touche pas à ça, l'enfant, tu pourrais te faire mal.
Ok.
Ben oui. Je peux-tu tout faire en même temps, toi?
Oh, that's funny. How'd you know I was looking at your diaper? You got eyes in the back of your head, old man?
Ah, oh, la belle pétarade. En 17 que c'était. Et le Kaiser, il se souvient de moi avec ma belle carabine. Bang, bang, que je lui disais. Bang, bang, bang. Ah, le bon temps.
The guy's awesome.
Dans mon temps, c'était comme sur l'image. On était vrai, fiers, forts, puis on avait le bon lieu de notre bord.
OK.
Mon beau bonnet du beau temps. Puis ma ceinture, où ce que je glissais mon flasque. Le monde tournait plus rond quand on s'habillait top de main.
All right. Well, thank you, sir, for your hospitality. I will be back when I find you some caribou. Yes, I indeed will. Out. So, other than being shot by this old man, is there anything else to do here? Don't see anything off in the distance. I could go down there. And also to this shed. Don't have a key for that. Okay. Ooh. Is that a lake down there? Yeah, that's Lake Atamepec. Cool. Nice view. All right. Well, I know what this guy is for then. This time we're gonna back up. Oops. Okay. What did I just smash into? The shed? Or a rock or something? Actually, can I save? No. Why not?
There, Carl had fed his mind, but had forgotten the harsh reality that his body also needed nourishment, especially in the dead of winter.
Aw, crap. Do I have any food? No? Damn it, I forgot to eat. Oh, God! Oh, God. Okay. Well, let's keep going. Maybe the next place will have food. There was plenty to eat at the general store, though. I didn't go backwards, did I? This looks like the doctor's house. Ah, crap, I did go backwards. Damn it! I'm such a noob. Pull in here. Then we go, in reverse this way. There we go, perfect. Let's go the correct direction this time, Carl. That'd be great. Just great. Okay, that's the old cranky man. I want to make sure I haven't missed anything yet. Okay, it's coming up. It's coming up. Put that away. I don't want to crash. Not sure I can crash, but ooh. Where am I right now? There's a clearing here with some magical snow in it, or magical ice. I think he's gonna want this picture, but yeah. There is tracks though. It shows up in the picture, but not. Yeah. It doesn't show up, oh. Okay. It doesn't show up on the snow, but if I take a picture, it shows up. The icy cavern. Oh! Jesus. Criminy Jim Jims. Okay. Wait. Okay. Why can't I save the game? And why are those wolves running away? Maybe I should not go in here. Why didn't they attack me is what I want to know.
The cold seemed to be more brutal here than anywhere else. It
okay.
Seeped into bones and into every
okay.
breath to
All right.
get to the heart until it stopped.
I get it.
Carl
I
needed to be dressed
it.
In warm clothes to survive.
Okay, I understand. We can't go in there until we get the warm clothes. We can't get the warm clothes until we get the caribou. So let's go do that instead. Okay, I understand.
It was so cold. Already Carl did not feel his toes anymore.
It's okay. We'll get in the car and we'll warm up a little bit, maybe. Okay, maybe we won't warm up, but at least we won't freeze to death. So, this is the next turn. Aha! House of the Patriot. Well, let's just hope there's a fire. Some magical... Ooh, there's an axe. Magical ice as well. Nobody shoot me! Okay.
The place looked more like a pigsty than a house. A heavy stench of curdled milk, cheap alcohol, and boiled cauliflower filled the air.
Gross. Boiled cauliflower.
Rock music invaded the minds of men even in the remotest of places. The man didn't own a turntable, though, so there's that going for him.
Ooh.
Back then, in Africa and elsewhere, people were ready to take up arms to stand against the yoke of English imperialism. In Montreal, mailboxes were blown up, abductions were carried out, and violent manifestos were distributed to media outlets. But around here, in the great northernmost, all a man could do is curse out loud against the faraway evil and pray for the revolution to arise. That man, by any reckoning, was from that very stock.
Quebec liberation will happen by force or not at all. We will prevail. All right.
Régin Blouin. Seems like that pig had a name after all.
Régin Blouin. Got his ID. Cards.
The rag reeked of fermented vomit.
Gross.
Carl wondered how one could bear to live in such gross and horrid conditions.
I have no idea. Clearly he was a pig, but I got caribou.
You had to be out of your mind to cook up white whiskey at home. The all-surrounding stench of alcohol alone was probably enough to gas a man to death.
A gun rack. A gun rack. Okay. Am I supposed to be surprised that there's no gun on the gun rack? There's a tomato. Can I eat that? Why wash dishes when the clean ones are within reach? Sure. Okay. These things here.
Carl now knew how to quench the drunkard's thirst.
White whiskey. Too much isn't a valid quantifier for that. Sherry wine for added mellowness. Spices, just a bit. This isn't a stew. Long Island iced tea. Gin fizz. Oh, delicious. Those are some good drinks. All right. Cupboards, just in case. Okay. Jars are overrated. Alright, I guess I need to, Oh, I can make a fire. Nice. We'll warm up. And then I can grab some more wood. Aha! Maybe I should put some logs in my car after I warm up. Might be a wise decision. I'm gonna go do that.
Carl felt that it was mission accomplished.
Hang on. What else can I put in there? Some of those. That's good. The logs.
With the wicked nectar in his hands.
The wicked nectar. But I'm not done exploring here. Like, I'd like to get some more wood if I could. Nice. Okay. And that's it, right? Now I go around back. Make sure I'm warm. I'm warm. Okay. Now, can we get around back? That is the question. Okay, it's just another... target practice.
With a homemade shooting range such as this, it wasn't hard to imagine a stray bullet ending its course inside the flesh of an unsuspecting passerby. Granted, Carl thought, there wasn't much in the way of passersby around here.
True, but I don't think this guy would have cared either way. Stuff. Hello.
An axe. Not yes. Too shabby. Carl felt he needed to protect himself.
It's very true. Damn it, Carl. Can I just chop this down and make a shortcut? Oh, there's a way to get around here, though. That's good. Let's dump these logs in the car here. Is there anything in this car I can grab? What are these metal poles for? I don't know. Nice. Okay. House of the Patriot. Grab more logs too. It doesn't seem to be a shortage of logs. Let's grab as much as we can. Okay. Never gonna have too much fire starting supplies, you know. Don't you know? Can I?
Ah. That truck had obviously seen its share of gravel roads. Carl wasn't a mechanic, but he could easily tell that only the most heartfelt prayer would bring this old beater back from its slumber. With that cold, however, it was more likely that it would wait until next spring to wake up.
That's okay. I don't need no thingy. I wonder if I could make another bottle. I have another empty bottle. Does that mean I could make another caribou?
Carl knew right away that the owner of this place wasn't a copper collector. No, this was a junkman's base of operations.
A junkman?
The guy definitely seemed like quite the expert in scavenging scrap metal, with or without permission, surely.
He sounds like a douchebag.
In the right hands, red metal could sell like hotcakes.
Okay, I want to try cooking on this.
You had to be out of your mind to cook up white whiskey at home.
Fine.
The all surrounding stench of alcohol alone.
There we go. Now I can save.
It was probably enough to gas a man to death.
Okay. I'm going to end the episode here, everyone. Hope you're enjoying this so far. I actually didn't take a break between this video and the last one, so I don't know. I don't know what you guys thought so far, but yeah, I'm really enjoying it. So I'm probably going to keep playing it for now. Thank you so much for watching. And let me know what you think in the comments below. Hit the like and subscribe if you want to see more. And I'll be back next time with some more Kona. Bye-bye.